Serena Williams 2-for-2 at Wimbledon, wins in singles, miss. Wimbledon, England. Serena Williams walked into her news conference at Wimbledon holding her phone, a full bottle of water, and the statistics sheet that reinforced what was clear from watching her third round singles victory Saturday. She is as close to being back to her best as she's been in a while. Williams, hampered for much of this season by injuries or illness, took a step forward against 18-time seeded Julia Gurevich, a powerful hitter in her own right, who lost to the American in last year's semifinals at the All England Club. Sure enough, Williams hit her set up to 120 miles per hour, within a tournament best 71% of her first serve, never faced so much as win break point, and win 6-3, 6-4. "It's been an arduous year for me," said Williams, who has competed only 12 times in 2019 until this week, mostly because of the bothersome left knee that finally is pain-free. "So every match, I'm hoping to improve some. Maybe it was a good thing she played twice Saturday, then." About 4.5 hours after getting past Gurevich at number 1-4, Williams headed out to center court for her much-valued debut as Andy Murray's teammate in mixed doubles. Other than when slid near the net when she lost her footing in the first set, she was fine and lasted off. Williams looked good during the 6-4, 6-1 win against Andreas Mies and Alisa Barty, including smacking win serve at 122 miles per hour, equaling the fastest hit in singles by any woman, her, naturally, during the tournament. "Andy and I both love the competition. I know we both want to do well," Williams said. "We're not here just for show." She rarely is. But if Williams is going to win an 8th singles championship at Wimbledon, and a record-tying 24th Grand Slam singles title overall, she will want more performances like the one she gave against Gurevich. "Forceful, yes, but nothing was forced. I play pretty good when I'm calm, but also super intense, just finding the balance in between there," the 37-year-old Williams said. "So it's a hard balance to find, because sometimes when I'm too calm, I don't have enough energy. Still trying to find that balance." Two more key stats on the paper she brought to her media session: she produced more winners than unforced errors, 19-16, while Gurevich finished with 32 forced errors, a reflection of just how difficult Williams can make it for opponents to handle shots she sent their way. Gurevich credited Williams with causing havoc with her return, as well. After averaging 10 aces in the first two rounds, Gurevich was limited to half that many. Of more significance, perhaps, was that Williams' singing replies to serves immediately put her in control of points. "It's fair to say that she built up enormous pressure with her return," Gurevich said. "That means I need to go to the limit in my service game." After the traditional middle Sunday off, action resumed Monday with all fourth round men's and women's singles matches. Williams, who is seeded 11, will face number 30 Carla Suarez Navarro, while the other matchups on the top half of the women's field established Saturday are number 1 Ash Barty, who has a 15-time match winning streak, against unseeded Allison Rich of the U.S., number 21 Ellis Mertens against Barbara Strykova, and two-time champion Petra Kvitova against number 19 Johanna Kunz of Britain. On the bottom half, it will be the 15-year-old American sensation Coco Gauff versus number 7 Simona Halep, number 3 Carolina Pliskova versus Carolina Muchova, number 8 Elena Svitolina versus number 24 Petra Martic, and Viviane Mastrinska versus Shulai Zhang. In the men's draw, 8-time champion Roger Federer and 2-time winner Rafael Nadal both won in straight sets Saturday to move closer to a semi-final showdown. Federer's record 17th visit to the fourth round at Wimbledon will come against number 17 Matteo Berrettini, an Italian never before this far at the grass court tournament. Nadal, who defeated Joe Wilfried Tsonga 6-2, 6-3, 6-2, meets unseeded Joao Souza next. Number 8 Kei Nishikori meets Mikhail Kukushkin, Ang San Clary played Kenny Sandgren in the first week two matchup at Wimbledon between two American men since Pete Sampras beat Jan Michael Gandel in the 2000 quarterfinals. Kukushkin's 4-set victory over Jan Lennard Struff at court 12 was interrupted when a 65-year-old female spectator had to be resuscitated after collapsing. Sandgren beat number 12 Fabio Fognini 6-3, 7-6, 12-6-3 at Tiny Court 14, with its 318 seating capacity. Fognini unleashed a tirade in Italian at win moment, saying he wanted a bomb to explode at the All England club. He later said his comments came in the heat of the moment because he was upset about not playing well and the condition of the course grass. "If I offended anyone, I apologize," said the volatile Fognini, who was fined $500 at Wimbledon in 2014 for unsportsmanlike conduct and is in a Grand Slam probationary period after getting kicked out of the 2017 U.S. Open. "That definitely wasn't my intention. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe."